Hi there, and welcome to Straight Talk with Kevin and Kevin. My name's Kevin, and of course, this is Kevin as well.
How you doing?
Good. Okay. God bless you. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, yeah.
Christmas is 1 week from today.
Today.
Are you ready?
No. I got to go shopping for my wife. She doesn't watch the show, so she won't know that I haven't got
anything
yet.
There you go. That's because you guys live in Kaiser. You don't get the show in Kaiser.
No, we don't get the show in Comcast.
You don't even get the channel in Kaiser.
Unless you have Comcast cable.
We should change that.
I know we need to change that.
No. Even if you had Comcast in Kaiser, our channel doesn't show there.
Yeah. So Kaiser can't get it, so all the people...
So sorry. But so she won't know that you're not ready.
So are you ready for Christmas? Did you get Pastor Christie anything yet?
No. I had some ideas of what I want to give her, but I haven't gone out yet, so probably this weekend.
All the kids?
All the kids, I believe, are taken care of. We're going to... And you know what we did? We did something a little different today, and I don't know. Write us and give us your ideas. How do you handle it?
Yeah.
The first time we've ever done this, on Black Friday, you know how they get all those screaming deals?
Yeah.
Instead of us going out and giving our kids a budget to buy a gift for every one of their siblings, instead, we gave them the same budget, but to buy all their own gifts. So this year, they know exactly what they got.
Yeah.
But they got to shop for it.
But they don't get them till Christmas Day, right?
Right. So they shopped for it, they bought it, they gave us all of the things they bought, and then we wrapped them, and they're coming from their siblings, from their mom and dad, and blah, blah, blah.
I did that on one gift because I wanted to...
make sure you got it?
Yeah, I wanted an original NFL Wilson jersey, and I found them on... They were doing a special, and got it for like $40, the actual one that he wears on the field, which was regular $269, so I'm waiting for it to arrive at our house. And she says, you don't get to see it till Christmas Day.
That's right.
So, but that was a gift that I know that I'm getting.
I did not know that you were such a Wilson fan.
Yeah, he's a Christian man. I like
it. He is. So, and just, he's taking that team somewhere.
I just saw that testimony of him and his about his fiance and them abstaining until they get married and everything. So, pretty powerful.
He's a good guy. And... I don't know what team you're rooting for, but apparently we got two Seahawk fans right here.
Seahawks. Three games in a row.
I think it's only three? I thought they were at four or five.
Maybe four,
like the last six games they've won five.
They're saying they got to win the next couple, but they're playing. They have a pretty easy schedule.
Lost a couple good players to injuries, but...
Rawls was having...
The cool thing is God favors the Seahawks, so we should be okay. Today, what are we talking about?
We're still finishing up on expecting the new thing this year. And, you know, all of us, we have these New Year resolutions that we're going to do more of this and do that and get a workout scheme. But, you know, it's like, really, we should start actually following through with them and expect this year. I mean, I just been reading through, I know you had the conference about taking off the limits.
Right, no limits.
And
that
the
was
children,
2 years ago.
Children of Israel, I just preached it on Saturday about how we limit God so much. We put him in this box and we think he can only do this much, but he's really this huge and we got to magnify him. And he's bigger than cancer. He's bigger than debt. He's bigger than anything. But we put him in this box and he can only do this much. When he's a huge God and he's the creator of the universe, he spoke the world into existence, and we limit him so much, and the children of Israel limited him by their doubt and their unbelief, not believing in him. And sometimes we make the circumstances bigger than God when God's bigger than any circumstances that we may face, even though at the time it seems that's how the devil does. He presses in and makes it seem like this, you'll never get through this. Oh, I'm never going to fix my marriage. My children are never going to serve the Lord.
Right.
Never going to get these debts paid. I'm always going to be behind on my bills, you know? So he tries to illuminate that instead of us illuminating God.
Yeah, you know, I was listening to, I think it was Stephen Furtick. I can't remember. Someone recently. We'll give Pastor Stephen Furtick the credit.
Yeah.
He may not have preached this, but I know he would. But there's different levels of faith that really produce results in the eyes of God. And one, you know, there's one level of faith that it's like your circumstantial faith. And that means, you know, something's happening to you, so you call out, you cry out. It's like, you know, oh my gosh, I can't pay my bills. God, I need help. And there's that faith in your circumstances because you need help.
Right.
And then you go all the way through these other levels of faith, but the real true faith is that relational faith where you can have faith in God even when you don't need help or even when the expectation of your answered prayer is not met. You know, it's kind of like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. We've talked about this in the past, where they said, you know, we know that our God can save us, but even if he doesn't, we're still not going to bow down because we serve the only God. And what kind of faith do we have to produce results? Do we have only circumstantial faith, or do we have that faith that continues to give God praise even when it's not?
Same as like Daniel. Daniel, you know, because he had such a great relationship with the Lord, even when they said, even when he was falsely accused and he was going to get thrown in the lion's den, he said he went and prayed, even when he knew the decree was already written saying that, you know, anybody that doesn't pray to Darius or whatever, the king or Nebuchadnezzar, which one of them is Darius, said, you know, you're going to get thrown in the lion. But he just, because he had that relationship with the Lord, he just trusted God, even though this thing and went down. He said, I'm not going to stop praying.
Right.
I'm going to keep that relationship tight with God, and God delivered him from the lion's den. So that's a key, you know, of expecting things this year, is keeping that relationship, getting connected back. If you're not connected with God, or you strayed away, or you're just kind of, sometimes you get that coasting Christian, you know, that roller coaster Christian, or coasting, you're just coasting in life. I don't want to be a coaster Christian. I don't want to just coast and just be. I want to be pressing up, pressing into God. And when you're doing that, when you're pressing into God, your problems that seem huge start getting smaller, because when you're pressing into God, you realize how huge He is. Mm-hmm. He never stops being huge, but when you don't press into God, your circumstances seem overwhelming.
Yeah.
And they seem like they're so big, and they seem like there's no way you can get them. And that's the problem, is that there's no way you can fix them.
Yeah.
You got to put it in God's hands, you know?
Yeah.
And I was just listening to, I believe it was Jesse, or actually Mark Hankins, he was saying about, you know, well, how am I supposed to get this? How am I supposed to get this? How am I going to get this house or get this building? And he goes, I didn't tell you to get the building.
Uh-huh.
I said, I want you to believe that I can get it for you. The difference is that you don't have to try to bring it in your hands. You just got to believe that God can, and then he will, according to his word.
Yeah.
And so
2016 is coming up, and there's a lot of things we need to believe for. You know, some people need to believe God for healing of their body. Many people have been diagnosed with cancer, different diseases, different things, and you know, they're struggling right now in their health, and they're in a lot of pain, chronic pain. And we want to believe with them that God has the power to heal.
Yeah, I think we should do a series on healing, you know, healing for the whole man, because this week I got attacked with, you know, cold and stuff, and I usually don't get sick.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I just dug into the Word of God. What did I do? When I'm going through a trial, I put on Gloria Copeland, she had put on her healing stuff. I was listening to healing scriptures, quoting the Word and stuff, and speaking to it. Well, guess what? Even though I had these cold symptoms, they start... I feel better today, and they start going away quickly. Mm-hmm. And it felt like I was miserable in the natural, but then I started putting the Word of God on it and said, God sent his Word to heal us. Mm-hmm. By Jesus' stripes, we were healed.
Right.
Why do you think Jesus was born?
That's right.
To this earth was to abolish and to destroy the works of the enemy.
Yeah.
And so that's what we're celebrating too, about Jesus being born. But man, all the great things that he has done for us.
I think 2016, we've talked about this last week and for a couple weeks now, I think 2016 is going to be a game changer for us personally, for my wife and I, for my family, for our churches, for our ministries, for the families in our church. I believe it's going to be a game-changing year for many of us. In fact, on January 1st, we're having a New Year's launch service, which is going to be, I believe, a Friday night, and I think you know him, Evangelist Lino. He's a member of our church. He's going to be preaching with me. We're going to tag team, and I believe that service is going to be a game changer. I believe there's going to be healing in that service, deliverance in that service, freedom. I mean, it's all going to take place on New Year's Day. I just figured, you know, let's expect the new things of God and start out right. You know, we have a tendency as people to just talk about it a lot.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of talk in the churches, in the Christian world, and in our lives personally, we talk a lot. But it's time for us to do something about what we believe and respond and act upon what we believe. If you believe you're healed, then start acting like you're healed and stop being depressed. If you believe you're free, then stop acting like you're still bound. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We got to change the way we respond.
And the way faith works too, you know, how God's power starts coming to you is when you don't look at your circumstance and glorify that, as you start start acting like, you know, my bills are paid and start acting like you're healed, guess what? Your body starts feeling better and the power of God starts coming in because of your faith in God mm-hmm. instead of faith, fear in the circumstances mm-hmm. and stuff. So I know as I start reading the word and instead of talking the symptoms and people saying, oh, yes, somebody asked me, are you not feeling good? I said, yeah, I'm battling, but, you know, I'm healed.
Yeah.
You know, and so because people don't know if they're out in the world, they don't, you know, they're not spiritual. You know, they just think, oh, right. yeah, you don't sound right and stuff. Right. So they start confessing it on you and stuff. And it's like, you got to watch all that, what you speak out of your mouth, because when you speak God's word, the power of God starts illuminating your body and starts taking out those symptoms mm-hmm. and things like that. So a lot of times you got to watch, we said this before, watching what you say. This in 2016, I mean, I really want to get in our church and really watching what they say
yeah.
and watching their confession, what they're yeah. saying over their marriages yeah. or their life, their family, and saying, oh yeah, my brother, he'll never come to the Lord. I said, don't say that. You know, I mean, because I'm glad people, you know, my grandma didn't give up on me.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when I was out in the world, people saying, oh yeah, Kevin will never change, man. I mean, somebody a long time ago found out I was a pastor. You go, wow, man, I can't believe he's a pastor. He's like freaking out, like, yeah, I used to be this, but now I'm this.
Yeah.
They could never, going from my old life, they never thought, but you should, as you're tuning in, you should expect that it doesn't matter where you're at right now. It just right. matters where you're going to end up.
That's right.
Where you're going to end up, what your destiny is, what
That's
your
right.
what your desire is. Just like I have this scripture here in Psalms 37. It says, you know, here's the key. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land. Feed on his faithfulness. God's faithful. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires.
That's right.
I mean, how many are you should be excited about the things of God. You know, every time you get to go to church or hear his word, we're supposed to be delighting him. He said he gives you the desires.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't even say your needs. He said your desires.
That's
I
right.
mean, how many desires do we have for your church and yeah, our churches,
yeah,
you know, for
sure,
this place to
sure.
just, you know, be packed
yeah,
out
sure.
and people getting saved and seeing
uh-huh.
people at the altar getting healed
mm-hmm.
of terminal diseases. I mean, that's what we're expecting this year, that
yeah.
God's power is going to manifest in our service like never before. And it's like, well, what do you mean it's going to matter? Well, because we're believing for it.
Yeah.
The ones that believe for it, like the lady with the issue of blood and the two blind men that came to Jesus, they said, you know, he said, Jesus goes, what, do you believe I can do this? And he said, yeah, Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And boom, they walked away seeing.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, it's just your expectant. You got to put your expectant on, believe that God wants you to have your desires, which we have to trust in the Lord.
Yeah. Let me ask you something, PK. Is it possible that people aren't receiving something new, not because God doesn't want them to have something new, but because they're stuck in what the old was.
Yeah, the old.
You know,
yeah.
They're stuck in the old ways, and
yeah.
and they're stuck in their past, and they look at that so much that they can't see the new right in front of them.
Or, like, they're trying to do something new, but they keep on trying to do it the old way.
The old way.
They're doing it the old way, and they revert back to the old ways and stuff, and instead of saying, oh, I got to change things. I got to do something different.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You know, some people that want to change their style, they go to a stylist, right?
Right.
I said, yeah, man, I'm still in the 80s. I want to get in 2015. So it's like, you know, so can you help me?
Yeah.
I said, yeah, they go in and you see that show and I saw on the show where they throw all their old clothes away
uh-huh.
and they're going,
what happened?
There goes my parachute pants. What are you doing? It's like, and
did you have some?
No.
I
no,
did.
I had the bell bottoms instead. You have parachute pants?
Oh yeah.
With the zippers?
Of course, man. I carry
wow.
my cardboard box around with me, and we
man,
our boom box,
you
and
must
we
have been
break
a,
dance
you must
right
have been
in the park.
A thriller.
Oh, I was a thriller. I was a thriller.
No, but you have to make changes. You got to get rid of some things, and you got to do new things, different things.
Yeah.
God's always doing fresh and new.
Yeah, in fact, Isaiah 43, 18 through 19, I was going to open with this. It says, remember ye not the former things, in other words, the past.
Right.
Stop remembering the past, neither consider, don't even consider the old ways. For behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Our whole mindset was like, well, how could there be a river in the desert? It's the desert. It's dry sand. It's
right.
the desert. And we grew up thinking that. That's the way we believed. That's the way we knew it. That's the way we were educated. And he says, I want you to not even think about the past. I don't even want you to consider what you learned in the past. Because what I'm going to do today is you can have a river in the desert.
Yep.
And we have a hard time accepting that. But God is saying, what you knew you could not do in the past, you can do today.
Yeah, that I mean, means, God wants to do new things. We just have to believe, you know. And I was just singing it, you know, because that song, you know, DC talking, I don't even know
yeah,
DC
talking about
God
yep.
is doing a new thing. Yep. And that's what he said, new thing, you know. God is doing it.
I mean, really, he even changed the way you spell thing.
Yeah,
because
he said thang.
Thang.
Like
I mean,
the south.
There's a significant detail there, you yeah. know. It's like, I want you to see the new thing.
Yeah, so he changed it. And so God wants to do new things in our life. And a lot of us get stuck, like, this can never change. I never can do new things. I can't, you know, I can't change my body. I can't, you know, this is the body I'm born with. No, I've seen transformations of people that they didn't like the way their body was. They go
right.
in. And they start working out, they lose all this weight, and they lost like a second person.
Right.
You see them, they lose like 100 pounds, and they said, you know what, this year, I'm not going to give up, and they start taking it one day at a time.
Mm-hmm.
You can't lose the weight in 1 month, you
mm-hmm.
know?
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not healthy if you do, but if you start doing it and going to the gym, I'm going to make this a lifestyle. See, the difference is when you make God, the Lord of your life, it's got to be a life.
Yes.
It's got to be a life change. It shouldn't be like a season. Okay, I'm going to serve God for 6 months,
mm-hmm.
get everything back that I need, and then I'm just going to go back to doing what I want to do.
Mm-hmm.
The same thing with working out. It's got to be something that you do
mm-hmm.
daily, like
mm-hmm.
picking up your Bible, spending time with your family. It's got to
mm-hmm.
be something that's part of you. Otherwise, you won't succeed at it. You'll lose the weight. You'll go back to eating your old ways, you know,
mm-hmm.
going back to the McDonald's drive-thru and the Taco Bell, and all that stuff, and then you'll gain all the weight, and then you'll be frustrated again because you didn't stick
yeah.
with it. You didn't expect the great thing. Didn't
mm-hmm.
You got to stick with that new thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it also says in Philippians 3:13, "No, dear brothers and sisters, I have not achieved it, but I focus on this one thing," and it's this one thing, forgetting the past
yep.
and looking forward to what lies ahead. So I'm going to not think about my past and the mess ups and the screw ups that I was, that I, you know, that I lived back then.
Yep.
And I'm going to focus on this one thing, and that's what lies ahead. God, what do you have for me in 2016? What is the new thing in 2016, or the new thing in 2016?
The new thing, yeah.
I'm going to focus on that. I'm not going to look behind me.
Yeah, that's a lot of it. We got to put, you know, our failures behind us, or even some of the things that happened last year, the good things that happened. You think,
come
well,
on
man,
now.
You think, could God beat this?
Mm-hmm.
You got to realize that God can do better and
mm-hmm.
bigger than what he did last year. I mean, even though in the Bible, we have all these great testimonies of Abraham having a baby, you know, at 100 years old, and his
right.
wife 90, and, you know, the parting of the Red Sea, but God said that he would do greater works through us.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, than
yeah.
what he did then.
Yeah.
So we got to expect that he can top.
Absolutely.
He can top what he did last week. We should
mm-hmm.
expect in our services
mm-hmm.
that, wow, man, that wasn't that powerful. I mean, we talk about a service, wasn't that a powerful service last week? We should say, well, guess what he's going to do this week?
Yeah.
Look what he's going to do this year.
Yeah.
Look what he's going to do each week.
Yeah.
That's what, like my Pastor Gloria, my wife, she'll say, well, yeah, this was good this week, but what do you think he's going to do next week? We
mm-hmm.
should expect that he's going to do more miracles, save more people. And the same thing with you in your home. You should expect that your marriage is not going, just going to be mundane, just barely get by. You should expect that it's going to go to the next level. Your children or whatever, your job. You know, just go to job, you punch your clock, you go home, you know, and you have that, like, mentality. I just can't wait till I have the weekend. Can't wait till Friday.
Yep.
You know, it's like our payday or whatever. I mean, that's not the way that we live. We got to have vision. We got to have
yeah.
we got to have vision for our life. We got to expect bigger things, you know, not just for today, but for our future.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, what's our future of our church? You know, like, you know, I'm challenging myself. What I got to do different this
mm-hmm.
year
mm-hmm.
for our church to go to the next level?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What do I got to do different in me? What do
yep.
I got to change? What leadership skills do I got to? What time do I got to sacrifice to get myself to become a better leader and
yeah.
be a better pastor?
Yeah.
So to make those changes, you're tuning in. What things do you have to do?
Mm-hmm.
And the Word will guide you, give
That's
you
right.
wisdom, and help you to make those changes,
That's
but
right.
get connected to people, get connected to your church, get connected to good leaders. Find somebody I mean, when I was doing bodybuilding shows, I found somebody that was the best in his field that had won shows after shows and was phenomenal at the gym. And I got his help, and he helped me with my diet, and he helped me with training. And I found somebody that was the best. I didn't find somebody that was just like me. Mm-hmm. I found somebody that had achieved bigger mm-hmm. than I even thought I could ever do to help me.
Yeah.
And the same thing with ministry or whatever. You like find the biggest, somebody's got this huge church or doing huge things. Like, okay, what are they doing? What can you do in your church?
Yeah. What can you do in your church?
Right?
You know, I love what you said about, you know, we talked about forgetting the past, but it's not just forgetting the ugly stuff. I've said a lot about the ugly stuff, forgetting about who we were and the mess ups we did, but you're right. We have to forget about the victories as well. If we get stuck on our victories from 20 years ago, then we won't be able to receive the new victories 20 years from now.
Yep.
Because we're still celebrating the 20-year victory from a long time ago.
Yep.
We need to put that down and say, you know what, that was back then. This is tomorrow. This is today. And let's not get stuck in our own Hall of Fame from 20 years ago. And let's talk about the new victories that God wants for our life, for our families, for our churches, for our ministries.
Yep. I mean, it's good. That's good. We need to look at it that way. And so if we want to go to the next level, we can't. It's great to look at the victories, but you also got to say, okay, Lord, man, I know you can top that victory, mm-hmm. you know? And I know I have teams in football that they had great, great achievements and, you know, the teams of the past, but that's awesome to look back, but I'm thinking about now.
Yeah.
What's the team doing now?
I can give you an example.
I remember the Seahawks couldn't win a game.
That's true. I remember those days. And so, but I was still a fan. I was still a fan.
You know, back in Jim Zorn and Argent, you know, back when they just had a few good players, but they were always like the laughing stock of the league. But but now they changed. They made some changes, you know. So we can't look back at our past and our failures.
Or our victories.
You got to believe that God can top all those. And he can put your past behind you and press towards those things this year. Press towards them and don't give up. Mm-hmm. Don't start into the new year, you know, a month into it or 2 months. And then you say, oh, this doesn't work. You know, the word doesn't work. No, it works. Mm-hmm. You just stopped working it. Mm-hmm. You know, you gave up. The word never fails. It never mm-hmm. returns void. You gave up on the thing. You gave up. You don't give up on your marriage. Don't give up on your job. Don't give up on your career. Don't give up on your church. Don't give up on life and stuff. It's like you can't go into it. A lot of people, they go into it. They say to the gym, you know, that the first 2 months of the year, it's going to be packed. And then after that, it filters out.
Yeah.
Because people start doing it, but then they give up.
Yeah.
Because it's so hard. They seem like it's hard. Yeah, I said, well, it's called working out.
Yeah.
It's not easy.
Yeah. You know, I remember when I was a youth pastor, I had a great victory years ago back in the late 80s, early 90s. And I was a youth pastor that took a youth group from about, I don't know, 6 or 7 kids. And we grew it in 1 year to about 150 every Wednesday. Kicked the adults out of the sanctuary because we needed more space. And that was a great victory. But that was like back in the late 80s, early 90s, and my tactics of winning these kids and drawing their attention and all that was very, very old. I can't take that strategy and say, hey, Pastor Randy, who's my youth pastor today in 2015, and go, look at all of these cut and paste graphics that I have. Because we literally, back in the day, cut them with scissors and pasted them on flyers and made copies that way. We couldn't do that today. All those tactics from before, even though it was a great win for us and we grew a youth group that way, we're not gonna grow it that way today with cut and paste and you know, that sort of thing. We don't do that. Today, they don't even know what paper is.
You know? It's all paperless.
Yeah, I mean,
Everything's on your phone.
What if we went on the street and my daughter got a real big compliment. I only got a few minutes left and it's all end with this. My daughter got a really big compliment because she does a lot of my 60 Second Devos with me. Someone recognized her the other day and thought she was a celebrity, and she got all tickled and excited, right? And she noticed that on one of these Devos that my daughter is on, we had like almost 800 views. Almost 800 views in a very short time. And people were just going like, man, you got 800 views and your daughter is awesome. But now let me ask you something. What if we took a camera, VHS, recorded it on VHS tape, and then went out in downtown and tried to get people, hey, I got this 60-second Devo, and look at my daughter, so cute. We want to give you this VHS tape.
Yeah.
We would not get 800 views. We wouldn't get one view because nobody has a VHS player, right? We got to forget the past and expect the new. So we got a couple minutes left. You got a closing thought for us?
I just think this year, you know, 2016, don't expect less out of God. Expect God's best.
Yeah.
And don't put him in a box. Don't put him in this box. Don't limit God at all because he's unlimited in the areas, any area of your life. So, do we tell anybody about our churches and stuff?
No, we want to connect with you in person. So before we close out, we want to just connect with you. You can go to our website, Pastor Kevin Pemble. Tell them where you meet, what time.
Yeah, we meet here at 210 Liberty downtown at 6 p.m. on Saturday night. So if you want a Saturday night church or evening church, that's us. And
6 p.m.
6 p.m. down here. And you can find our website is www.lifechangersalem.com. And you also connect with us on Facebook. Our Facebook page also gives you directions to the church. Come down, check us out, and enjoy a Saturday night service.
Awesome. And if you are more on a Sunday morning type of churchgoer, you can come join us at Connection Life Church, same building, 210 Liberty Street Southeast, across from the Grand Hotel. You can get all of our times and events every Sunday morning at 10 a.m. You can get that information at our website, www.clcsalem.com. org, and you can find us online on Facebook, Twitter, and all that stuff too. We want to connect with you. And if this show has touched you, if it's blessed you, write in, let us know about it. We want to know that you're blessed. We want to celebrate with you. But right now, we want to pray with you. We're expecting new things for you in 2016. I believe this is the last recorded episode for the year, because next year they won't be open. So this will be the last recorded episode. So thank you for tuning in all the weeks that you've tuned in, and we're going to have a great 2016. So shall I pray?
Yeah.
All right. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for 2015. But God, we're not going to be stuck in 2015, 2014, or any year before. But God, we want to look forward to 2016 and the new thing that you're doing in all of our lives. God, we thank you for our viewers. We thank you for the ups and the downs and everything, because we know that in all things you work to be good for those who love you and are called by your name. And we know that these viewers today, God, you have a new thing for them that is going to be good. So, Lord, we embrace that. We believe that. And we're going to act upon what we believe today, as Pastor Kevin shared. We got to act upon what we believe today. And, Lord, we want to walk with you. So in 2016, we pray for your blessings, and we'll be careful to give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thanks you for tuning in.
God bless you. This has been Straight Talk with Kevin and Kevin. Happy New Year's. Merry Christmas, and we'll see you in 2016.
Thanks.